Let's talk about how we can solve this non-factorable quadratic equation by completing the square. Have a look. First, we want to add 3 to both sides because we just want to have these two terms on the left-hand side. So x squared plus 8x. And leave a space. This is equal to 3 after we add 3 to both sides. Next, we have to figure out what number to add right here, and I call the number magic number. To do so, first, we have to make sure that we have a 1 in front of the x squared, which it is, then we can proceed. We will have to look at this value, which is positive 8, and then we are going to take 1 half of 8. Let me write it down right here. And then we have to square that. So now let's work this out. This is 4, and then we square that, we get 16. So we will have to add 16 to both sides. After we have done this, you will notice that the left-hand side is factorable. Better yet, we will get a perfect square every single time. We get x plus 4 times x plus 4, which is just x plus 4 squared. And then right-hand side, of course, is just equal to 19. Then we can just take the square roots to both sides, get rid of this and that, and then we get x plus 4 equals plus or minus square root of 19. Subtract 4 to both sides, we can get x equals negative 4, yeah, and then plus or minus square root of 19. You can just leave the answer like this, and then we're done. So now, let me talk about why we add 1 half of this value to both sides. Have a look. So here we have x squared plus 8x. Let's talk about what x squared represents geometrically. X squared literally means a squared with each side being equal to x. And I can draw that right here. Now next, 8 times x. We can draw 8 like this and x like that, but we will end up with a rectangle. We don't want that. Instead, we are going to take half of 8, and that's exactly what we did. If we take half of 8, that will give us 4. So I'm going to put 4 right here, and then I'm going to put another 4 right here. And together I'm adding that with x. Now this way you will see that this portion is 4 times x, which is 4x. And then this right here, it's also going to give you 4 times x, which is 4x. So together we have the 8x. And of course earlier this right here is the x squared that we had. Now, if you do this, you can see that we are missing a little corner. And what's this corner? Yes, this is the part that we will think how to add so that we can literally complete the squared. This little corner is precisely 4 times 4. That's why we will have to do this and then square that. And of course, that will give us 16. So we will have to add 16 to this in order to literally complete the square. That's why we added 16 here. And of course, when you're solving an equation, whatever you do to one side, you do it to the other side as well, and that's how it works. Let's try another question. Here we have x squared plus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0. Again, it's not factorable. Step 1, move this to the other side. So we have x squared plus 3x. Leave a space, and we get negative 1. Then, make sure we have a 1 before we proceed, which we do. Sometimes if you have, let's say, 2, then just divide everybody by 2, then you can still do the same. Then we are going to look at this number, which is 3. We take half of 3. And notice this time, because 3 is an odd number, when we take half of it, we have to deal with fraction. It's not so bad, though, I would say. Anyways, take half of 3 and then square that, which is 3 halves squared. So 3 squared is 9, 2 squared is 4. That means we will have to add 9 over 4 to both sides. And then on the left-hand side, we can for sure to complete the squared, and we will get x plus 3 over 2. It's always this number. Plus 3 over 2 squared. And then on the right hand side, let's just go ahead and add the fractions real quick. negative 1 is the same as negative 4 over 4 plus 9 over 4. Same denominator already, so that will be 5 over 4. So 5 over 4. Then take the square root, both sides. Cancel, cancel, and don't forget the plus or minus. Here, x is equal to, put this to the other side, we have negative 3 over 2, and then we have the plus or minus. Square root of a fraction, take square root of 5, well, it's an irrational number, so leave it. But square root of 4 is just a 2 on the bottom, so just like that. If you would like, you can put them together, and you can write that as negative 3, and then plus or minus on the top, square root of 5, all over 2. That's it.